This video is brought to you by FineFine. Hey guys, this is Kevin and welcome back to another video. Today we're going to take a look at FineFine's K688 USB XLR dynamic mic. If you're a beginner content creator and you want to start leveling up your gear, then the first piece of equipment I recommend upgrading is audio. You can sit through a bad video, but if the audio sucks, you're not going to watch it. In this video, I'll go over the design, audio quality, and do some sound tests. So let's get into it. Okay, the mic comes in this black and red box, and a big thank you to FineFine for sending this my way. When you open the box, you'll see a user's guide, which I'll read later. Let's move this foam piece out of the way, and here's the mic itself. It looks and feels really nice. There's also an adapter for the boom arm and a USB-C to USB-A cable. And that's everything in the box. Now let's take a close look at the mic itself. It's pretty light. The outer part is made out of plastic, but the inside is metal. And the included windscreen feels super soft like a plush toy. It also sits right up against the end of the mic. On the top is a tap the mute button. Along the back, there's an XLR and USB-C port, and a headphone jack so you can monitor the audio in real time. There's also two knobs, the one on top to adjust the volume, and the one on the bottom to adjust the gain. The built-in shock mount is also made out of metal and is very sturdy. The mic doesn't even want to move at all. Now there's no stand included in the box, but the best way to use this mic is with a boom arm. If you're interested in the K688, I'll leave a link in the description box below. I'm going to attach it to my existing boom arm, connect everything up, and see how it looks. Alright, here's the completed setup. Mic attached to the boom arm, and the cable is neatly tucked away. It's very clean and professional. It's connected via USB-C at the moment since I'm a simple plug-and-play type of person, but if I ever evolve as a content creator, I'll upgrade to XLR. And I don't need to worry about buying another mic since it's already built in. Compared to the first product I reviewed from FineFine, the AmpliGame USB microphone, this whole mic and boom arm combination frees up desk space and unwanted noise when you're live streaming or rage quitting. Since it's a dynamic mic, you want to speak into the end of the mic around 2 to 6 inches away and slightly off axis to avoid pop sounds. So the audio quality is really good, and I wasn't expecting that at all. In fact, I'm using the K688 right now to record this voiceover. The quality is almost on par with my high-end mic, and this only costs $80, which is not bad at all. Here are some sound tests, and I'll let you be the judge on which one sounds the best. Hey guys, it's Kevin, and this is an audio test from the K688 mic. Hey guys, it's Kevin, and this is an audio test from the AmpliGame mic. Hey guys, it's Kevin, and this is an audio test from a high-end mic. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments down below. I do add some noise removal and EQ to my voiceovers, but all these are unedited straight from each mic. I also have some sound tests for everyday noise you're likely to have while using this mic. First up, here are some typing sounds from a Magic Keyboard. Next up are typing sounds from a mechanical keyboard. Now I'm going to have my Mac fan spin up at full blast. And finally, I'll open my window and door. And that's it for my review of the FineFine K688. There's not much I would change about it other than having a little more weight to it and a USB-C to USB-C cable. But that's just me. Overall, I'm very impressed with the build and audio quality of this mic, especially for the price. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't already, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you'll be notified when I post new videos. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye!